diplomat here has met has gotten to this Bactrian town. So let us offer some map information to them. They want trade rights in exchange of map information. I do like that. However, I'm going to instead pay. So we're going to offer, we'll say, 600 for the map information. They accept the agreement, so now we have trade with them, and we get to know a little bit more of the world there. Alright, we're going to try to see if we can get some map information from the Mada as well. Let's see here. They accept. It doesn't look like their empire has grown a little bit. Now they've gotten to the north here. I definitely have to build a watchtower to block off these mountains here. So once again, let's try our best to... Here we go. So right here I can build a fort. It's not the best location, but it will have to do. Now I'm going to send in a unit here to garrison it. And actually, I'm going to have to build myself another unit of Thangrabada because I want to fill out this garrison as well. Alright, Teoke could use a building. Let's see here, what will work? Well, you know what, I have to up the population growth rate, so let's build some sewers here. Alright, so looks like my scout came out with another small town here called Neh. I almost wish it started with an M, and then it would be Meh. Where do you live? Meh. Wherever. Alright, that was lame. Anyway, so that's a possible expansion, but I have a feeling by the time I get an army over there, I'm going to be at war with somebody. Well, look at this. These stupid rebels have shown up again. I think after they're done killing the family member that was around here, they came back to their regular brigand ways, so... Well, let's deal with them. Yeah, we'll do this. How am I doing here with population order? Pretty much the same as it was before. Okay, so next turn, I'm going to give these guys a bit of a whoop. Oh, it looks like Vaya here got himself a mathematician. Very nice. Alright, now it's time to kick some rebel butt. These guys have been a pain in my rear end. So it looks like I'm against, a Takabara and two Sparabara. So this will be prove to be interesting. I'll see you on the battle map. Alright, so mobility will be the key here. Let's see here. Where are they deployed? They are deployed right there. Okay. So we'll see if they're going to move. But in the meantime, let's bring up my... Takabara, we'll move them right here. That was my Thangrabada. My Takabara, I'll move right here. And we're going to circle around my General's Bodyguard way down here, and my Asabari up here. I'm going to take both these guys off of fire at will, because I'm going to want them to fire the missiles at an appropriate amount of time. Okay, so I'm just trying to circle them around with my cavalry here. This has caused them to kind of run around in disarray. So that's a bonus. We've brought up my Thakrabada to about here. And, aha! Looks like they're going to be coming for me. So this is going to be perfect. I'm going to stop these guys, have them fire, and have these guys attack them along their flank. And bring up my cavalry to hit them in the rear, and I'm going to put my general back on fire at will and try to distract these guys while I do this charge. Let's just take a look here. Bam, right in the center, right where their general is. This still will give me a good shot for my archers here. Oh, I've killed the enemy general already. That's a big plus. Sure enough, my general is doing a pretty good job there, and now they've broken. So we're going to bring my Takabara right there, clean up the rest of these Sparabara with my Asabari, and we're going to... I'll have to bring up my Thangrabada right about here. So that worked quite nicely. Big thing about, well, warfare and even in war gaming, you really have to take advantage of a moment to strike. For example, up here, these guys are downhill, and it's heavy cavalry without shields, so I'm going to try to do a striking maneuver on them right behind them. I'm going to attack these Sparabara with my Thakravada. Gonna charge them there. And let's see if we can't make these guys break. Oh, they're shaken. Oh, now they're broken. Excellent. Wonderful. So now we're going to just bring these guys up here behind, do a rear charge, and then that should be the battle. Just give you a close-up of the Sparabara fighting my Takabara. And here we are. Let's do ourselves a bit of a charge. Right from the rear. There we are. That's the battle. So that was a clear victory with 477 kills and 49 losses. And with that, we'll send my general back to Harmosia. And these guys back to their homeland of Patragada. So, based on some of the comments I've been getting with this campaign, I thought I'd issue a bit of a disclaimer. First of all, this one isn't as action-packed as my Norman invasion or my Romus Erectum, mostly because I'm not given a really, really large army to, kick a lot of butt with, right? This is kind of empire building from the very beginning stages. Also, even though it would be really fun to completely emulate what Cyrus the Great did, this is not going to be possible. First of all, Cyrus here is already 48 years old. And secondly, this particular game here, the game engine, doesn't really allow for one huge decisive battle that determines the conquering of an empire. If you look at the history of Cyrus the Great, he fought, I think, 3 major battles against the Medians, about 3 or 4 against the Babylonians, and a couple against the Ionians. And after that, all the territories were there. This, unfortunately, doesn't work like that, unlike, say, for example, Empire Total War, where the entire country, in some cases, at least in Europe, are just one region. That's the entire country. That's it, right? This one is divided into little territories. And I could take 90% of, say, the Babylonians, and they'd still be resisting, right? It's only until they're whittled down to a couple of provinces left that they ever consider becoming a vassal state. So, unfortunately, it doesn't look like Cyrus is going to actually emulate the empire that he's going to build. However, there's plenty of time in this campaign, and I will, when I start a war, I will actually fight a war like it's a war. I won't completely turtle up, but right now, because I'm not at war, I have to make as much money as possible. So that's the goal of this campaign right now. Alright, so I'm going to disband this final unit of Thanvabara, and now Eustasius can now be upgraded to a larger city. Alright, and so since we still are at peace, I'm going to build a trade caravan here in Patragada and continue to accumulate wealth. Alright, so I'm going to take the remnants of some of the forces from Patragada and Hatilda there. I'm going to keep my garrison here in Harmosia because I want to keep the happiness high and the tax high. So I'm going to move, first of all, I'm going to move the army over here. Now I'm going to just take a look and see what they have. Alright, so they have some Takabara, some Sparabara, some Thavrabada, and some Asabari. So we're pretty similar if I had some Sparabara, but we want to make sure I win. So we're going to recruit some mercenaries. We're going to say 2 Thavrabada, a Sparabara, another Takabara. And that should be enough to win this particular battle. So let's attack them. They'll accept my terms and meet me in the field, so I'll see you on the battle map. So, of course, the enemy has parked themselves on top of a hill as a good defensive position. So I have 2 choices on how to approach it. Up here, this is quite rocky terrain, so I don't want to approach through there. I can approach through their right, through here, or I can approach through their left. I'm choosing a left at this point, solely because if they wish to stay on this hill and turn and face me, they're going to be impeded by these rocks, which means they may overflow over onto lower ground, which would work to my advantage. So we'll see if that works out properly. Sure enough, it looks like this has dispersed the enemy a little bit, and sure enough, their spears have now been exposed, with their archers far, far away. So what I'm going to do is just bring up my forces, rain death upon the Sparabara with my own Zandabada, and go from there. I don't want to bring my cavalry out too much, because they almost match me in cavalry, with the exception of my commander, and I want to keep my commander more with the bulk of my army. So we're going to wait to see, have them make a move with their cavalry before I bring out my own. Alright, so I've been quite lucky. I've gotten to a position where a few of my Thangrabada can't actually fire upon them without getting any sort of returning fire. So we're going to just wait here and have me whittle down their forces just a little bit, pick off some of their spearmen before I go in for the kill. I do have a missile advantage, so I might as well use it, eh? Alright, now I've moved up my forces a little bit, and now unfortunately, no, I'm still not in range of their enemy Thangrabada. It's probably because these rocks are blocking their line of sight. I've also put my infantry in front of my Thangrabada. Actually, I should move these guys up a little bit more, just to protect them from a possible cavalry charge. In the past, I have noticed that I'm sometimes just a little slow when it comes to bringing up my spearmen to protect my archers, so hopefully this will make things a little bit easier. Alright, so I'm going to try something a little on the riskier side. I'm going to actually leave my general's bodyguard from the bulk of this army here, and I'm actually going to swing them around this way, because I do want to make a strike upon their archers, but I am wary of the enemy Asubari, but my general's bodyguard should offer a little bit of an advantage towards me, because they are tougher cavalry. But I want to really just make a quick strike with my Asubari, so we'll see how that works out. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Asubari right here, and I'm going to make a strike upon their Thangrabada, and I'm going to bring my general's bodyguard right about here. So if they do try to... Oh, I got stuck on some rocks here. Gosh darn it. There we are. Come on. Oh. So, sure enough, my Asubari are dispersing these Thangrabada, and they are making a move towards me as well, so that's good. Let's just reform everything. Let's bring up my general's bodyguard a little bit. And now let's quickly reform over here. Let's see here, we'll do this. I know that should do it. So sure enough, their Asubari have charged my own. And so now I'm going to bring in my general's bodyguard. Okay, I'm going to retreat my Asubari now, because they're getting slaughtered. We killed the enemy general. He was with the Thangrabada. So now their Asubari they are wavering, and now they're broken. And that's victory. So there we go, that was a nice clean kill. Alright, so that was a clear victory with 507 kills and 58 losses. With that victory in the field, I'm going to continue my way on to Pura, but I'm actually going... These Asubari are pretty beleaguered, and I'm not going to need them for siege battle. So I'm going to start them on the long walk back to Patrigada to be retrained. But the rest of these forces will hit Pura next turn. Alright, and in Harmosia, I'm actually going to build some land clearance. That way it will up my population growth so I can tax a little bit higher. Plus, farming can get you income as well, so it's an extra bonus.